Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Also click the bell icon so that you will be notified every time a new video is posted. So let's get into the topic.
Today's topic is the balance of payments. This is for economy for UPSC and RBI grade B exams. So let's talk about this balance of payments. The balance of payments is a statement that contains the transactions made by residents of a particular country with the rest of the world for a specific time period. It is nothing but it's a statement of accounts that one country or resident of a particular country made with the rest of the world during a specific period of time. Take 1 year like that. It is also known as balance of international payments and it is often abbreviated as BOP. It should not be confused for balance of trade. Balance of trade is different from balance of payments. Balance of payments summarizes all transactions that countries, individuals, companies and government bodies complete with individuals, companies and government bodies outside the country. That means the companies, individuals and government bodies outside the country, they may be of another country or multiple different countries. These transactions consist of imports and exports of goods, services and capital, as well as transfer of payments such as foreign aid and remittances. So these transactions, what they include are imports and exports of goods, services and capital. Along with this, they also include transfer of payments such as foreign aids and remittances. Balance of payments is different from balance of trade. The balance of payments divides transactions into two accounts. Actually, according to the International Monetary Fund, there are three accounts. One is these two are current account and capital account, and another account is the financial account. It will be included in the capital accounts in countries like India. Sometimes the capital account is also called the financial account. Let's see the current account. The current account includes transactions in goods, services, investment income and current transfer. The current account includes the transactions in goods, services, investment income and current transfer. It consists of four major components. These four major components, first one is the visible trade. This is a net of export and imports of goods of visible items. This means it includes the export and imports of goods of visible items. It is also known as trade balance. Imports are higher than exports, then there will be a trade deficit. If there are more imports and the export than the exports, that it is known as trade deficit. Similarly, when the exports are higher than imports, then it is known as trade surplus. Next one is the invisible trade. This is the net of exports and imports of services of invisible items. So a visible trade is nothing but export and imports of visible items. Invisible trade is nothing but export and imports of services of invisible items. They include shipping, IT department services, banking and insurance services. The third component of the current account is unilateral transfers to and from abroad. It refers to the payments that are not factor payments. They are one-way transactions. That is one-way transaction. Either they may be coming from outside the country or going from our country. So they are one-way transactions. For example, gifts or donations sent to the resident of a country by a non-resident relative. These all comes under the current account under unilateral transfers to and from abroad. The fourth part of this, fourth component of this current account includes the income receipts and payments. This includes factor payments and receipts. They are generally rent on the property, interest on the capital and profits on investments. So the four components of this current account are visible trade, which means the visible exports and imports, invisible trade, in that means the exports and imports, net on the services, shipping, IT, banking and insurance services, unilateral transfers to and from abroad, that means it includes only, it is one-way transactions, they include any gifts or donations, income receipts or payments, they include property, rent on property, interest on the capital and profits on investments. The second is the capital account. This account shows the change in ownership of foreign assets and transactions in financial instruments. It is used to finance the deficit in a current account or observe the surplus in the current account. So this account shows the change in the ownership of foreign asset or transaction in financial instrument. If there is any change in the ownership or transactions in the financial instrument, it is used to finance the deficit. It has three major components: loan to and borrowings from abroad. It consists of all loans and borrowings given to and received from abroad. It includes both private sector loans as well as public sector loans. So the first thing in this capital account, the first major component of the capital account is loans to and borrowings from abroad. It consists of all loans and borrowings given to or received from abroad. It includes both private sector loans as well as public sector loans. The second one is the investments to or from abroad. These are investments made by non-residents in shares in the home country or investment in real estate in any other country. The second major component of this capital account is the investments to or from abroad. These are investments made by non-residents of any country. They made investments in shares in the home country or investment in real estate in any other country. The third component is the changes in foreign exchange reserves. Foreign exchange reserves are maintained by the central bank to control the exchange rate and ultimately balance the balance of payment if it is not. So foreign exchange reserves are maintained by the central bank to control the exchange rate and to maintain the balance of payments. Note that any transaction resulting in a payment to foreigners is entered as debit and is given a negative sign. Any transaction result in a receipt from foreigners is entered as credit and is given a positive sign. When a transaction is made to the foreigners, it is considered as debit and we have to give it a negative sign. Similarly, when a transaction is coming from foreigners, it is entered as credit and it should be given a positive sign. Current account deficit is financed by surplus in the current capital account, and similarly capital account surplus is financed by the deficit in the current account. When there is a deficit in the current account, it will be balanced or financed by the surplus in the capital account. Similarly, when there is a surplus in the current account, it will be financed by the deficit in the capital account. This goes in both ways. This can be done by borrowing more money from abroad or lending more money to non-residents. We can do this. The balancing can be done by borrowing more money from abroad or lending more money to the non-residents. The International Monetary Fund accounting standards of the balance of payment statement divides international transactions into three accounts. They are current account, the capital account, and the financial account. So we already discussed this. The International Monetary Fund accounting standards of the balance of payment statement, it divides the international transactions into three accounts. They are the current account, capital account, and the financial account. Where the current account should be balanced by capital account and financial account transactions. So these two are used, the capital account and the financial account are used to balance the current account transactions. But in countries like India, the financial account is included in the capital account itself. So we have only two major accounts in the international transactions. They are current account and the capital account. We don't have the financial account. It is included in the capital account itself. Let's see what is the financial account and what it includes. This is a record of all transactions for financial investment. It includes direct investment. This is net investment from abroad. The financial account is nothing but it's a record of all transactions for financial investments. It includes direct investment. This is a net investment from abroad. Portfolio investments. These are financial flows such as purchase of bonds, gilts, or savings in the banks. Next one is the short-term monetary flows. It is known as hot money flow. Can a country have a trade deficit and a current account surplus simultaneously? Yes, it is possible when the earnings from services and private transfers are or greater than the trade deficit, then a country can have both at the same time, current account trade deficit and current account surplus. Balance of payment surplus and deficit. A country that has a deficit in its current account, that means spending more abroad than it receives from sales to the rest of the world, must finance it by selling assets or by borrowing abroad. When a country has a deficit in its current account, that means it spends more abroad than it receives from sales to the rest of the world, it must finance it by selling assets or by borrowing abroad. So any current account deficit is of necessity financed by a net capital inflow. Any current account deficit is to be financed by a net capital inflow. Alternatively, the country could engage in official reserve transactions, running down its reserves of foreign exchange in the case of a deficit by selling foreign currency in the foreign exchange matter. So the country could, what it should do, it could engage in official reserve transactions, running down its reserves of foreign exchange in the case of a deficit by selling foreign currency in the foreign exchange market. The decrease in official reserves is called the overall balance of payment deficit. Similarly, increase in official reserves is called the overall balance of payment surplus. When the official reserves, they are decreased, then it is called overall balance of payment deficit. When the official reserves are increased, it is known as overall balance of payment surplus. The basic premise is that the monetary authorities are the ultimate financiers of any deficit in the balance of payments or recipients of any surplus. So ultimately, who is the responsibility bearer of these monetary financiers of these transactions is the monetary authorities, like the central banks and all. If there is any deficit, they have to take care. If there is any surplus, they will receive that. The balance of payments deficit or surplus is obtained after adding the current and the capital account balances. Whether the balance of payment deficit or surplus, it is obtained by adding current and capital account balances. This was the amount of addition to official reserves. A country is said to be in balance of payment equilibrium when the sum of its current account and its non-reserve capital account is equals to zero, so that the current account balance is financed entirely by the international lending without reserve movements. That means simply when the current account and the capital account, their balance, their sum is equals to zero, then we can say that the country is in the balance of payments equilibrium. That is, what all the imports are equal to the exports. In the, for easy understanding, what we are sending outside and what is coming inside into our country, when they both are equal and their sum is equals to zero, and that means at that time a country is said to be in balance of payments equilibrium. That means that time we don't have to sell official extra reserves and we don't have to borrow money from other countries and all. Note that the official reserve transactions are more relevant under a regime of steady exchange rates than when the exchange rates are floating. These transactions will be more relevant when the exchange rate is steady. For a particular currency, if the exchange rate is steady and not fluctuating, then these official transactions will be more relevant. Autonomous transactions. International economic transactions are called autonomous when transactions are made independently of the state of the balance of payment. For example, due to profit motive. So international economic transactions, when are they called autonomous? Means when they are made independently of the state of, without the independence of the the balance of payments. For a motive of profit, to gain profit, such transactions are called autonomous. These items are called above the line items in the balance of payment. Balance of payments is said to be in surplus if the autonomous receipts are greater than the autonomous payments. Similarly, the balance of payment is said to be in deficit if the autonomous receipts are less than the autonomous payment. This is similar like balance of payment deficit and surplus. When the autonomous receipts are greater and the payments are greater than the autonomous payments, then the balance of payment is said to be surplus. Similarly, when the receipts are less than the payments, then it is called balance of payment deficit. Accommodating transactions. The accommodating transactions are termed as below the line items of the balance of payments. What we learned about the autonomous transactions is they are the above the line line items in the balance of payment, but the autonomous accommodating transactions, they are the below the line line items, they are the below the line items of the balance of payment. These are determined by net consequences of the autonomous items, that is whether the balance of payment is in surplus or deficit. So these are determined by the net consequences of the autonomous item, whether the balance of payment is in surplus or deficit. The official reserve transactions are seen as the accommodating items in the balance of payments, all other being autonomous. So the official reserve transactions are only seen as accommodating transaction, and the rest are all treated as autonomous. Errors and omissions. These constitute the third element in the balance of payments apart from current and the capital accounts, which is the balancing item reflecting our inability to record all international transactions accurately. When some of the international transactions, they are omitted or they are not recorded properly, there comes the matter of errors and omissions. Significance. The importance of the balance of payments. The balance of payments data is important to a lot of users. Investment managers, government policy makers, the central bank, businessmen, etc. all make use of the balance of payments data to make important decisions. So this balance of payment data is important to a lot of users. They may be including investment managers, government policy makers, central bank, businessmen, etc. Based on these details of the data of the balance of payment, they will make the important decisions. Balance of payment data is affected by vital macroeconomic variables such as exchange rate, price levels, interest rates, employment, and the GDP. This data, the balance of payment data, the factors that affect this data are some of the important macroeconomic variables. They include exchange rate, price levels, interest rates, employment, and GDP. And fiscal policies were formed in a way to achieve very specific objectives, which generally exert a significant impact on the balance of payment. So fiscal policies are also, they have an impact on the balance of payment. So they are formed in such a way to achieve very specific objectives so that there will be a proper and significant impact on balance of payments. Policies can be formed with the object used to induce or curb foreign inflows and outflows. Businesses use balance of payments to analyze the market potential of a country, especially in short term. A country with a large trade deficit is not as likely to import as much as a country with the trade surplus. So what will these people do when we are thinking, when a country is thinking about exporting goods from importing goods from another country? They will check this balance of payment data. When there is trade deficit, what it will be happening, because that country, it won't be able to import goods and services. So it will be the trade, doing trade with that country will not be so much profitable. If there is a large trade deficit, the government may adopt a policy of trade restrictions such as quota or tariffs. So these are all the things about the balance of payment, the three major components of the capital account, current account, and the financial account. These are the three major components according to the International Monetary Fund. But countries like India, they include the financial account along with the capital account. So there are other things like balance of trade deficit, balance of trade surplus, accommodating account transactions and accounting transactions, errors and omissions, and the significance of balance of payment. So these are all the things we learned today. I hope you liked it, guys.
Thank you, friends. Hope you liked it. Please do like it and share it with your friends. Also, let me know your opinions in the comment section. Thank you all. Have a great time.